Hello, this is Tony at Tony's Music and the Administrator of Doodley and Turnley PNGs. I'm on my AVS tools folder, and as you can see, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 different tools that are supplied when you buy the lifetime account with them, and you only pay once and you have them for life, and they give you updates and everything, so it's well worth it. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you a bit of a start to AVS video editor, which is just one of the tools, and I'll just give you a walkthrough of it and let you see what it's like. Right, let's just when you first put it on, this is what comes up, start project. You can watch the video guides, and you just click on that and it should come up with the video guides, right? And you've got a choice at the top. You can either import media files, capture from camera, or capture from the screen, which is gives you a good idea, so choose different ways of doing it. You can create a blank project, or open an existing project, or save current project. And then it gives you current project there and sample project, so there's a sample project there for you. Sometimes you'll get it saying, do you want to add a new set of stuff to the media library or whatever, and you just click on it to do that if you want to. Up the top here you've got your file, normal file menus. So you got your new project, open project, reopen project, save project as, import media library, export media library, import media, capture video from screen, and produce and exit. That's on your first file drop down list. And then the second one is undo, redo object, which is giving you a choice of tools you can use when the object is selected. And line, gives you a chance to move up the line, enable line, lock line, clear line, and etc. I assume that's down here. And your chapters, that's for when you're doing a DVD, I suppose, the chapters. It's not allowing you to hold it at the moment, because obviously we're not there. We haven't got the stuff on there. And there's your aspect ratio, and you can customise it as well. You got your volume and balance there, and settings down here. So if you want to have a look at the settings, you got general settings, processing, preview, acceleration, environment as well. So you got all those different choices. Right, now the view is timeline or storyboard, zoom in, zoom out, zoom to fit, section, projects, media library, transitions, video effects, text, voice, and this menu. And you've got view. View and sort by, but you need things in there for it to come up with those. Then you've got your help menu, show info tips, check for updates on start, check for updates, AVS homepage, AVS support page, email us, and about. Alright, so that's pretty reasonable anyway. And you've got your main scene area here, and you've got your timeline here, which is quite big. Right, now, and the tools across here are your, that's your projects, your media library. If you've got any media on here, they'll come in this area, or you just click that and bring them in. You've got your samples and that current for the current project here, and you can get your transitions, video effects here, and text here, voiceovers there as well. You just click on that. You've got a disk menu, so you can do a disk menu for the disk and produce that way, and you've got different choices on the producing as well. There's your play button and your stop button, go to start, go to end, and what's that one, I forgot that one, next scene. So if you've got scenes on it like that, right, then you've got your full screen, snapshot, mute, and volume. And you've got your thing here, playback speed, that's what that is, right? And here, this area here, you've got current project all in there, your videos that are in there, images that are in there or audio in there. And if you've got a lot of stuff, you can take that down to make them smaller. So they're being to instead of being big images or icons, there'll be smaller icons or a list. I'll show you that in the stickers. Let's put the stickers on. Well, the stickers are there right now. I'll do this and it'll go down like that. So you can have it like that. We can have it back up like that. Right, so they've done that on purpose to give you a bit of extra stuff. But let's start off with there. Right, first of all, you've got the current project, which has got nothing. It's where I've added nothing yet. Got samples, which is the videos that they've got, and there's, I think that might be a still, that one, but a lot of them are like this. Them are videos. That's a still, or should be, I believe that's a still. Yeah, these ones are still with them little icons on, I believe. Yeah, them are stills. So these three are stills. Them, that one's just a music, that one's video. So all them are videos there with them ones on, and these are stills here. Now you got some stills, some videos, and that's a video I put on myself there. Right, so that's that one. The backgrounds, you've got the colour, just colour backgrounds like that. So you got a lot of them. Them are just stills anyway. They're Then you got patterns. These are all stills as well. But there's a lot of stills there. There's about 33 stills there. Patterns, and then you got 234 stickers, and these are all stills as well. Right, so there's quite a bit there really. And then you go to transitions, which you, these are the things that I bought it for, because the transitions on here are absolutely fantastic. I think I love these transitions. Some of the transitions I've got on here are really, really powerful, I think. Like the water ones, the ripples, ripples inside, ripples outside, and sphere. And you've got bricks coming down, bricks going up, all sorts of bricks, different ways, and then hexagonal bricks. You got triangular bricks, and you know, all sorts of different things. And then you got the normal twist ones, flippings, slats going across, slats going down, open up with like a trapdoor opening, and other things like that. And you got weird different ways of doing it. You got the kind of page turners and all sorts of different page turn things like that, and sort of like that. You got some other kind of things here. There's a lot of them on here. It's, I don't know how many is all together. There's 578 transitions on this. That's a hell of a lot of different transitions to choose from. And I think they're brilliant. Some of these are really good. I absolutely love their transitions on this, to be honest. I think they're really good. So that's pretty good, isn't it? There's a lot there of them. So that's one of the reasons I bought it, was the transitions, was that wow effect really. And then if you get to the video effects, there's about 84 different ones here, and you got like the normal stuff there. And you, a bit more further down, you got the glass mosaic, grid mosaic, and puzzle canvas snow. You got the snow coming down. That's a pretty good one. And you can change up the length of the use as well and stuff like that with them. And the resample type of thing. And you got other things here, like different shapes on them, and having invert ellipse and things like that, and the ellipse, everything like that. Right, that's pretty good. The text is a bit less impressive really, because I mean there ain't that many. I mean they've got some nice ones, but they ain't got in anywhere near as many as some of the other ones really, but you got some ordinary stuff like the things like that going across, going up, and yeah, good cast roll for the credits rolls. It's pretty good, and you got some nice colours on these text, and animations are different, like different ways of doing the text, and you can change them how you want to within a certain reason, so they're not too bad, but you know, could do with more different styles of text and different ways of showing them, I suppose. That's the only one Grim's got, is the text are not very good really, and they haven't got any music on it, but the video, the voice over there, you can put your voice over there, you just do, you click your source, microphone, USB, master volume, professional, and format, what format you want to use, and options, multiplayer, delay recording, time limit, and that, right, so that's pretty reasonable. So you can do that, and it comes down here somewhere, and you can put your music in there if you've got some music for it, and your disk menu is there, and it gives you three working areas there like that, so you can click on the working area you want to use at any time. You have to click on this to enable the disk menu as well, and you can work on the pages here, and you put in what videos you want, where you want them and everything like that. Right, so that's how it works. As well as that, you've got here the storyboard. You can click that to change it to timeline. You got your volume balance here. You can balance the music down or up. And then you got, what's this one? I don't know what that one is. But gives you different choices anyway, so you can balance them up according to what you think for each part. And then you've got, this gives you the aspect ratio, and you can zoom in and zoom out on the timeline with that. You've got full screen there for the whole of that, goes to full screen, or you can take a snapshot. You can mute the video, and you can up and down the volume on there, and this is the speed of the video. You can make it go faster or slower. I'll leave it at one. So that's that. And as you can see on the actual timeline, you've got the buttons that you use. Your first line is your main video goes on there, and you've got show audio, and you can take it off if you want to. Then the next one, you can add your video effects here, and you can lock them or you can disable the line. And this one's for video overlays. You put your overlays in here, and you can use audio, and you can lock them or disable the line. There's your texts there, and that, and you got your music, and your voice recording goes there, right? So it's pretty reasonable for what it is. I hope you've liked this walkthrough of AVS video editor. If you've got any questions, please feel free to ask me about it. But you've got a choice here. You've got capture, screen capture as well with it, and it's a reasonably good app. I'm gonna do some more videos on how to do things on it if you wish in the future, but please let me know how you enjoyed this video. All right, and don't forget to subscribe to Tony's Music. Thank you.